What's this program running on my machine? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. You know, as you use Windows, there will be many programs running. Some you'll see, and some, many, running in the background. My primary desktop machine has 406 running as I updated the article that this video accompanies. And yeah, that's a lot. The Windows 11 virtual machine I use for examples, which we're going to look at here in a minute, has only around 150. Only. What are all those things running on my machine? I need to start with a little bit of terminology. We talk about programs, but Windows tends to think in terms of processes. They're sometimes used interchangeably, but they're not quite the same. Edge or Word or Thunderbird are all what you and I would call programs. They're what we see when we run something. These are also often called apps or applications. Sometimes there's a very slight difference between the two, but the fact is they're all computer programs. Windows only sees what it calls processes. The difference is that a single program may or may not cause several separate processes to be run. Edge is a great example. Running a simple copy of Edge on my example machines causes 40 processes to be run. It's not a bad thing. It's not a good thing. It's just a thing. It's simply how the software has been architected to divide the load, to divide up its work. Throughout this video, I'm going to be looking at processes. In most cases, like the 40 Edge processes I have, it'll be obvious what program they relate to. In some cases, not. And I'll try and explain those as well. First, how do we get the list? Well, there's three ways that I like to do this. The one you already have available to you that is probably the most familiar is Task Manager. So we're going to go ahead and right-click on the taskbar and click on Task Manager. Now, there are a number of different tabs that are available here. In Windows 10, the tabs are across the top, but it's basically the same thing. Processes is the one we're going to start with. Processes is a great way of understanding, at a high level, what's running on your machine. You can see that Task Manager, for example, is here. If I fire up Edge and minimize it right away so we're not having to look at it, you can see that Microsoft Edge shows up right away. Now, the fact that this is changing all the time, the order is changing, is simply because I have it sorted by who's using the most CPU. And that changes over time, depending on what you're doing, what the programs are doing. Instead, I'm going to go ahead and sort by name. Here, this list explicitly calls out apps. Again, apps, applications, programs, pretty much all the same thing. This shows Microsoft Edge as a single thing. But remember, I said there's a bunch of processes involved. Well, that's what the expansion is for. If I expand this by clicking on this greater than sign, boom, there's the 28 processes that are involved in Microsoft Edge. And remember, all we've done with Edge so far is fired it up, it may have an extension or two loaded, and it's displaying a single web page. Task Manager itself has a single process. Task Manager. Now, if you're interested in diving a little deeper, I'll go ahead and expand Microsoft Edge again. You can right-click on any of these. I'll just right-click on Spare Renderer, whatever the heck that is, and click on Properties. What this does now is it tells you that this is an application. The application that it is that's actually behind this process is msedge.exe. And that file lives in this location. Program files x86, Microsoft Edge application. It all kind of sort of makes sense. Even if we didn't understand what Spare Renderer was, why it exists, or what it does, we at least know that it comes from Microsoft Edge. Now, another way to look at much the same information that is perhaps a little bit more blunt, I'll call it, is to use the Details tab. Details essentially gives us the same information, but by process. It doesn't bother to try and group things. It's just showing you all of the processes that are currently running on this machine, what their process ID is. Each process is given a number, whether it's running or not, who ran it, how much CPU it's using. And once again, if we wanted to, we can sort by CPU usage, how much memory it's using, and so forth. Interestingly enough, the description column, while it's way off to the right here, often has the most interesting information here. If I hover over it, you'll see that aggregatorhost.exe is Microsoft Aggregator Host, whatever that is. But it at least tells you that it came from Microsoft. Okay, so here's a list of, like I said, all the processes that are running on this machine. And you can see with only running Task Manager and Edge, we've got quite a few running. Another approach that I prefer to Task Manager is something called Process Explorer. You've probably heard me talk about it before. If we go over to the Microsoft Store and look for SysInternals Suite, this is a suite of tools, actually several tools, of which Process Explorer is a part. On this machine, I already have it installed, but to get Process Explorer, that's all you need to do. It's install the free SysInternals Suite. So we'll hit the start menu. I'll type in procexp or something close to it. And there it is, procexp, run the command. Now, Process Explorer shows much of the same information as the details pane of Task Manager. But in my opinion, it does it in a more visually useful way. If I make this thing a little bit bigger, you can see all of the specific processes that are running on your machine right now and in hierarchical order. Well, what does that mean? Well, if we take a look at WinInit here, WinInit.exe, that program started services.exe. Services.exe started ServiceHost.exe. This instance of ServiceHost.exe started SvchHost.exe and Start Menu Experience and Widgets.exe and a couple of instances of Runtime Broker and so forth. In other words, you can see where these programs came from. What program started this other program? Now, that's true even when you start a program, because what you're interacting with when you start a program is Explorer.exe right here. For example, when you start something like OneDrive or Google Drive or any of the other things that you might have running here, like I have CryptoMator running on this machine, that all happened due to what Explorer.exe did. Remember, Explorer.exe is the program that not only displays Windows File Explorer, but it also displays the taskbar at the bottom that you're interacting with and the start menu that you're using to start programs. So I find that pretty interesting. And again, like Task Manager, you can right-click on any of these things and get properties to give you a lot more information about what this specific tool is, what this specific program is, what this specific process is all about, where it is stored, what it's called, what its description is, and so forth. These are all good details that will help you understand what that process is. Where did it come from and why is it running on my machine? Now, I do want to include for completeness one other very useful tool, I guess I'd call it. I'm going to fire up Windows Command Prompt here, because sometimes you'd like to get that list in a way that you can do something with it, like copy paste it or share it with somebody who's trying to help you. That's the task list command in the command line. If I just run it, boom, there's a list again of all of the tasks that are running on this machine, all of the processes that are running on this machine. All right, great. It blew by. Of course, we can use more to do it a page at a time, so we can at least see what's going on. But what I find most useful, if we're going to do this, is to actually redirect the output to a file, list.txt. If I now try to run list.txt, well, that's a text file. So it's going to fire up Notepad. And now I can browse through whatever is in here. I can do things like count the number of lines. This is line number 201. So if I take off a couple of lines for the heading, the three or four lines that are here, that tells me I've got 198 processes running on this machine. Now remember, we've got a couple of utilities running, we've got a browser running, we've got Task Manager running, and we have Notepad running. And that's it. 200 processes, roughly, to make that happen. So task list, I wanted to include because in many cases, people want to get a list that they can do things with, that they can share or search on or whatever. Why are there so many? 200 on this machine, 460 on my machine. That's a lot. Okay, to begin with, no two machines are going to have the same list, because there are a lot of things that play into this. The number of processes running on your machine will depend on things like how much software you're explicitly choosing to run, such as when you fire up, in this case, the browser or Task Manager or Process Explorer or others. The software that you have installed on your machine that relies on other processes running all the time. As we saw, Google Drive has processes running. OneDrive has processes running. Other tools have processes running because in order to do the job we expect them to do, they need to be there. There's also sometimes software that you install on your machine that auto-starts. Even if you're not running a particular program, many will still have processes installed and running automatically when you sign in. The hardware you have installed on your machine can make a difference. Some devices will include processes that are required to support the hardware. Windows itself is a very complex operating system, and many of the processes you see are Windows. So, great. We know that there's a lot of them. We know how to see them. What the heck are they? Well, unfortunately, there's really no global answer to that. I will tell you this. Some are going to be very obvious based on their name alone, like Google Drive or Google Drive FS.exe. If you see cmd.exe, that's the command prompt. Windows Terminal.exe is the Windows Terminal. PowerShell.exe is the PowerShell. But there are definitely others that we don't have a clue on. So we can use Process Explorer to actually help us. For example, font drive host, font DRV host. If we right-click on it, you'll notice that Process Explorer includes this search online. That's going to use your default search engine, in my case, Google, and it will search the name. That's all it's really doing is searching for the name. Now, I want to throw out some caution here, because you'll get a lot of interesting search results. Some will not really tell you what the thing is. For example, in this case, we can see that the very first result is a Microsoft community entry where Font Drive Host is using too much RAM. Those kinds of questions and answers can often help you understand what something is and what it's about. Very often there'll be a description in those discussions. If we take a look at this Reddit thread, again, it's the same thing. These are questions and answers. Sometimes we end up with the exact answer we're looking for. What is Font Drive Host and why is it running? In this case, GroovyPost is a legitimate site. In fact, I know the owner. They actually do provide reasonable technical answers that you can trust. However, there are many, many results here that may or may not be legitimate. Many of these sites I recognize. File.net, I believe, is a legit. Malwarebytes, you probably already know. Tom's Hardware, it's a forum over there. Microsoft Learn. But many of these others I've never heard of before. Manage Engine. Medium. Somebody just wrote an article about what it might be. Spy Shelter. Never heard of that one. Here's the caution. Sometimes these sites are crafted for exactly what you're doing. You've got a program, you've got a file, you're trying to figure out what it does. They show up in the search results, and they may or may not tell you what it does. Some may distract you by saying, oh my gosh, it's malware. No. Oh my gosh, it could be malware. Well, yeah. Oh my gosh, you need to run our tool to tell you whether or not it's malware. Okay. No, I have a tool that tells me whether or not something is malware, and that's the security software I already have on my machine. So do the search, do the research, but be very skeptical of any site that ends up leading you to a suggestion that you need to take action that only they can provide. Now, there is one process that honestly deserves a little special attention. Close the browser here. You can see MS Edge just went away, except for the ones that it left running in the background behind. Service host, gosh, there's a lot of them. On my main machine of those 460 processes, 94 of them are service host. Service host, as its name implies, hosts services. If you take a look at Windows services, you'll see that Windows has a lot of services that are part of Windows. Each one of these is doing something to support one of those running services. I do have an article on it. What is service host and why is there more than one copy running? That will go into more detail, but the bottom line is it is very normal for there to be lots of copies of service host running, and it is not something to worry about. As I said, it's one of Microsoft's workhorse processes. Bottom line here is that most people come to this article because they've seen something on their machine that they don't understand and are looking for its origin or its purpose. Hopefully, I've given you some tips on how to see what's running on your machine and how to get some clues as to why. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/1851. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.